I wonder if I could put my Bravada Yuga right there. Will everyone just run away? Let's find out. Hello again, everyone. Well, the Black Friday madness is over. Now you can just relax, rest up a little bit, perhaps have an open-faced turkey sandwich or some turkey soup. Pack up your stuff for Christmas and or any other holidays that you may have been shopping for. You know, a little Valentine's Day here, a little St. Patty's Day there. And if I were living on the West Coast and I was a completely unattached psychopath, this is what I'd be doing on Black Friday. That's right, just admiring the Yuga Classic over here out on the beach. As you can see, I just had to get a little bit more, you know, sunset orange into it there. So I took out the blacktop looked great, and I thought it really made the bottom graphics pop. But I just had to introduce a little bit more sunrise orange here. We can. Wow, this is just such a beautiful scene, looking out at the sea. And we're back to me. Alright, let's take a look here at this van. Ooh, got sunglasses going. So, it actually changes the look a little bit. That's neat. As you can see, we went with the sunrise orange. We're still black on the roof. But now we've got the sunset orange pearlescent over it, so it's all a little bit orangey. Sisters from another mister. There you go. So this is going to be the kind of, I think, the final look for my Yuga. That's going to be, this is my version of the Mystery Machine. You know, it should have, it has all the actual colors as opposed to, you know, throwing in some dew yellow or something like that. Now, I've done a few performance upgrades to it just because they're on sale. It's on sale, you know. Rocking this out a little bit on the Black Friday. So it's got all the engine upgrades here. It's at, you know, level 4 on the ECM. It's got the turbo. And it's still very slow. And it's just darn silly, really. But what I've decided to do is, you know, for today's commentary, for days drifting around, is do a little bit more low-speed kind of day here. Let's stop down the bike shop and change to something a little bit different. Now, in the video where I got the BF400 and the Left Guard Blazer, I did a little bit of a kind of a shop tour down here, a little bit of a garage tour. You know, you've got the Shotaro, of course, which is just so darn fast. My Hakachu, which I love so much. You got the Hakachu Drag, BF400. This baby, it's just all about the looks here, too. You know, it's not a quick bike by any stretch. But just look at it. It's just cute. It's good. It's just looking awesome, cruising. This is your biker bike, for the most part. Then I got my Jeremy Clarkson bike from when they were in Vietnam. A Sanchez that I stole just because of the whole GTA Vice City-ness of it. An actual lost bike. We got the, you know, again, another Vice City throwback, a PCJ 600. My Blazer, my BF4. So anyway, I did this little tour of it not that long ago. You can see I've got basically entirely stock location here. This motorcycle club has got nothing new, really new going on. You know, here's the bathroom. You can see it's not a place you'd ever want to use the bathroom. And I've got a helmet on for no reason. Here's the office. With great posters and a laptop that I will probably never use, and people are going to keep calling me and say, hey, you know, you're missing out on all the great biker stuff. No, I'm not, really. I know what's going on there. It's going to be just like lots of driving around. Maybe you'll make a lot of money, but not what I feel like doing. I'll do that when I feel like doing it. Hey, yourself. You want to come down to the beach? Well, let's hang out for a little while. I'm a completely unattached psychopath. I know you're into that. Actually, I don't know that she's into that. That really... Eh, oh well. But at any rate, I had a thought. And the thought was... Maybe... Just to round things out. Because I've done that little tour in a video not that long ago. And then, when I did the... See, let's go green shirt. Let's go. Or should we go casual? Let's go casual. Or should I go shaggy? I was gonna actually name this shaggy, and it wouldn't let me. Believe it or not. Yeah, let's go shaggy for this one. That's why it's got a lowercase. I was trying anything. We'll take this. We'll take green shirt. All right, took green shirt. Let's take something completely different, though, than the Yuga Classic back. We'll grab the Shotaro, simply because it'll be quicker. But I was thinking, how about no,
hey.
No. Hey, hate yourself, no. I'm not using the laptop. Get off my back. All right? I bought the MC, and it's great because it's a garage. That's, you know, all I'm doing with that. There we got Shaggy on the Shotaro. It's a double S kind of thing, I guess. But not an SS. That's just creepy. But I thought, hey, you know what we can do here? Let's round this out a little bit. Let's at least get this covered. Let's do a generalized garage tour kind of thing. You can get to see what I've got going. While I talk about, you know, things that come to mind. You know, a little bit of a rambling video. Where the channel's going, what my plans are for the short term, what I've got set up, what I've not got set up. Let's do the tour part here first. Let's go to first person. Okay, here of course you've got, this is my Black Knight livery garage, okay? You can see there's a little bit of a theme, a little bit of Pittsburgh Steelers homage going on here. A lot of Black Knight black, a lot of Steeler yellow here. So we got the LOG, of course. This is my primary sports car for racing. You can see it's got the mud tires on, so it goes over bumps that little bit better. I don't know how much longer that hack's going to work, but I'm going to run with it while I can. And again, thanks Brophy1322 for that one. Now this is my gauntlet, and I really thought the gauntlet was going to be my go-to for a long time there, because it is much more stable in turns. It doesn't spin out on you very easily, so it's a little bit easier to drive. It's just a touch, for whatever reason, because it's got the power that it needs. I think, at least according to the engine rankings and all that kind of thing, the power bars on the stats are any meaning, it should be just as fast as the Dominator, but just for some reason isn't. It does look really good though. I do like that car. Now this Phoenix, this is actually the first car I ever had in the game. This is it. This is the first one I nabbed. And so this is a keeper for the long term. Every once in a while I'll take it out to the track. It doesn't fare badly, but it's definitely, you know, it's not the top car. It's just gonna look cool. I do like driving that. Now here, this is my Shafter here. Let's pop into this thing here. My benefactor Shafter. Oh, I really have to clean the coffee cup out on that. That's just... This was the top sedan runner, and I actually did steal this one. It's still my sedan racer. I haven't really raced it, because who races sedans anymore? There are a couple that are supposed to be faster, the LWB and the Armored, but I'm not sure, and the V12. So I have to test those and see which one's faster, eventually get the other cars. Maybe I get my sixth garage. I don't have six garages yet. But, so that's a utility one there. That's just in case I end up in a race. Now this one I picked up here, this Ruiner, simply because I saw it on the road and it was already painted this way. And so it's gotten some mods, but it was like, the car was perfect as I found it, just for the looks. And, you know, who doesn't love an 80s Camaro? So I had to grab that. Now, this is one of my first compacts. Grabbed this, modded up. That was when I was really, really into all black paint with pearlescent over it. That was going to be my main... All my cars were going to be like this. that got old after a little while. The Issy here is pretty quick. It's not the quickest, I don't think. And I've seen things, you know, flip-flopping up between what's the quickest car on this. I don't know that it's not a Mandela effect, but it's definitely not the Issy. But the Issy, you could be competitive with the Issy. And I keep it because I've done a lot of races with it, and it's a sentimental favorite, and it looks really cool when you're cruising with the top down. Now here, this is my primary coupe racer. This is... Check it out. The Zion. Listen to that motor. Look at the comfort. You're in the Zion here. Interestingly enough, not the most expensive coupe, but it does seem to come out on top in races. It is quick, and it handles very well. As you see, I've mounted the racing tires there. There it is. I love the paint job on this. You just kind of fall into the deep grayness of it. And so even though it's not exactly in the right color livery, this is my racing car, so I keep that as it is. Got the Desert Raid. Tricked out. Droned out. Yeah, the tires don't match, but I actually put off-roads on this, again, for the same reason, so I can get the performance enhancement. And I think they actually do run a little better than the stock off-roady looking tires. I think we that's a good thing to do there. Oh, now this. This is my entity. Oh, the entity. This is I've done so many races with this, and truth be told, I have races scheduled. They're scheduled in YouTube. You know, videos scheduled in YouTube out to March. Where I was racing with this so much. I have so many videos. It's all pre-RE7B nerf kind of stuff. Me taking the old school entity to the crowd. And just added the Ukuka label, of course. We didn't have that going before. But this is... I'm still not sure that I don't prefer this car in actual supercar races just yet. I still like the feel of it. I still like the grip. I know on paper, intellectually, that the RE7B should have more grip than this. It is the fastest car. I've done races against the two, and I'm faster in my RE7B than this, but it just feels really good. It looks really right. Love this car. Absolutely love it. Love cruising around in it. There you have this. Finally, my RE7B. The RE7B that I got, and then 2 days later it was nerfed. And you can say, well, no, it was fixed. It was a glitch. They fixed the glitch. And yes, I agree with all that. The point of whether it was nerfed doesn't matter whether it was nerfed properly. It had to be nerfed. I mean, watch the next videos for the next few months. You can see that the RE7B had to be nerfed. And that was on the receiving end of RE7B-ness. But that almost sounded dirty. As you can see, I've got the wheels mounted up here, the dirt wheels. I am seriously considering putting a livery on this just so, because the yellow livery with the beer kind of decals does look really good. This looks really good as well. I don't know. You'll see it in future videos. This is my main supercar racer right now. Until I have a lot of failures or something with it, and then I end up saying, you know what, I'm going to go back to what I know, and then I'll put some dirt tires on that black car over there, and we'll see what happens. But this is it. This is not all. I got other garages to go to, but this is my Black Knight garage, as you can see here. This is my Steelers livery garage, and now let's move on to the next one. So as I was saying, I've got racing videos planned out through March. I've got Fallout 4 videos through the end of the year, maybe into a little bit into January. I might pick up with that. And continue the quests in Fallout 4. I still haven't beaten the game. And the reason I haven't beaten the game is I want to be happy. And there's a certain... If you play Fallout 4 long enough, it does tend to take away from your energy levels. It's a little bit down. It just is. I mean, there's humor in it. And they do a great balance of humor. I love the game and all that kind of stuff. I just have to be in the right mood for it. And, except for a little bit of gameplay I did. What event was that for? Oh, that's right. I played a little bit on Election Day because I was going to do an Election Day special. And, you know, basically talking about geopolitical things and, you know, which candidate would be more likely to put us in a nuclear war. Then I started to think about how likely it would be that we would end up in a nuclear war, depending on who got in there. And it just got too depressing, and I scrapped the whole video. So, except for that, except for when I played it on Election Day, nothing here worth grabbing. Yeah, I haven't really played it since July. From July 4th, when I did my 4th of July update on that. Let's take a walk in here. So I don't know when I'm going to get back to Fallout 4. And I may even take a little break from racing, because I've been racing so much. Although sometimes you just feel like racing. That's, you know, I have one more. I have a new racing video that I either, by the time you've seen this, it will have either just gone up or it will be right after this, depending on how things get uploaded and edited and blah, blah, blah. But here, let's get into the garage tour part of it. This is kind of my my miscellaneous garage here. There's not a real theme to it, you know? As you can see, I really did fall in love with this gray. And that's my, you know, my gray peyote. It's my T-Bird. And it is a slow, not fast car. For a while, it was the best for sports classic racing because it did have a high top end. But other stuff than that is will crush it now. It's you don't want to try and go up against, you know, a Z-Type or, you know, anything else like that in this. This isn't, you know, this is not the racer that you want to deal with. This is another one of my earliest cars. I grabbed this one off the road. This is my Sentinel. It's maxed out. It is a viable racer. Has very nice handling, very nice, you know, it's very comfortable to drive. And, you know, sometimes I think I can drive faster in this than I can the Zion, simply because it has the right feel to it. I haven't really tested that 100%, but it's a keeper. You know, again, you can see I really, really dig that complicated gray. I think it was like something, it was some kind of pearlescent deal going on there. This is my XS, my Sentinel XS, which, you know, is a little bit more crazy. It's just, you know, it's got that street racer vibe. And this one, again, early car, one of my earliest cars that I nabbed off the road. And it's black with a red pearlescent finish. You know, that was the deal. You'll see more of this as things go on. Now, this is my Felon. Now, the Felon is another coupe. You know, the Felon, the XS, the Sentinel, the Zion, they're all viable racers. You can race any of them. The one thing I don't like about the Felon is if you hit a curb or you take a turn too fast, it'll flip. This is the flippiest car in game. And that makes it fun and it makes it interesting. But that's my Felon GT over here. With the gold paint job. It's a wonderful thing. Let's see, can we get the view from the inside on this? My Felon GT, my Lampadati Felon. Alright, that's just good for that. Now, here we have my Blista. Now, the Blista, it was, when I got it, and it was hard to find. You could only steal this car. You can't buy it, and it was the one to use for racing, supposedly. This was the compact that you're supposed to use for racing. Now, I think when they added the update to the game where the spoilers actually did something, I think that it has a little bit of a duck lip spoiler there. So, I mean, that should have helped it out. So somewhere along the line, you know, you see people argue that the Rhapsody is actually the car to use for races, and I actually did use that one for races for a few times here, and it turned out that was really doing well for me. So I've switched the Rhapsody is now my primary, you know, my primary compact racer. I keep wanting to say coupe because I've got this Felon in the background. So, you know, you'll get to see that one in a little bit. I still do race this one. I haven't geared it up with the proper tires. This is, again, it's another early car. You can see it's got pearlescent over black. And it's a keeper. It's a sentimental favorite. This should be my sentimental favorites room. But I do still race this, but not as much as I do the Mirthmobile. And we'll come to that in a little bit. Incidentally, according to the latest and greatest out there on the internet, the Brioso is now, in fact, the one to use. I don't own a Brioso. I've driven them. I've driven the stock versions of them. And they are good. I haven't had a great amount of luck with them. So I haven't bought a Brioso yet. It's on my list of things to get. You know, maybe that'll be a sixth garage car. you know, we'll look at that. You know, maybe we'll tuck it into the fifth garage. We'll see what happens. You know, we'll see. Actually, the fifth garage was probably my specials garage, so the fourth garage, that's maybe we'll tuck it in there. But for right now, that's where I stand with the compacts. This is an old favorite. Now let's look over here. This is actually it's a car I have that I keep telling myself I'm going to get rid of, and then I don't, because it's a Patriot, which is great for running into things mostly, unless you hit it just the right way, because it'll blow itself up on the front end. I've seen that happen. This was one of the cars I really, really, really wanted to get when I was first playing the game, because it just looks so perfectly Patriot. It looks so much like the Hummer. I was just like, this is going to be great. I gave it this really wild kind of orange paint job. It's got like a bright orange over a sunset orange. It's just great. And it just doesn't drive very fast at all. You can't use this for anything. So I don't know how much longer I'll keep it. I'll probably just, if now that we have a sixth garage, yeah, I'll probably leave this right here. Just so I can look at it every once in a while, but probably not drive it. Because there's definitely more capable stuff off-road and all that kind of thing. It's just here to look cool. This looks cool. Now, this was my first sedan. My first racer sedan. As you can see, again, blue over black. Blue on black, tears on a river. It isn't the fastest of the sedans. It does have extremely good handling, and it's extremely durable. I mean, this car is very hard to stop. You could feel it take a lot of damage before it slows down. So this was going to be my heist car, and it's still a very viable heist car. There's another car that completely obliterates it as far as, you know, usefulness for that kind of thing, and we'll get to that. More of a truck, really. But again, I hold on to this for sentimental value. I've actually thought about repainting it in a light tan so it looks like the car I drove off to my honeymoon with. We rented a Crown Vic. Was it a Grand Marquis? Might have been a Grand Marquis. Same car here, but you know, that was what we went to the airport in when we got married way back in the day. And it's actually got the wheels from the two of the cars that I drove, actually, you know, as first growing up. I learned to drive on a 77 Thunderbird, which had wheels most like that. And this one has the same thing. It's the same kind of big Ford sort of look to it, so that's why I decided to put those wheels on there. Now, this Issy, why would you have two Issies? Well, the other Issy is completely maxed out, and this one has a little softer suspension. I've done less to it. That's exactly the same paint job it had when I found it, when I ripped this off the street. And it was one of those things where I grabbed this car just to fool around, and it actually did some stunts successfully for me. And, you know, some wild stuff, you know, that big curving jump up that you have to fly up, and it landed that one. I'm like, you know, this car has a good feel to it. And there are certain tracks where I wasn't sure that the unmodified Issy wasn't a little bit easier to drive than the modified Issy. You know, Bahama West Mamma Mia, I thought this one was a little quicker. So I held on to it, and it's another sentimental favorite. Ah, the Sultan. You gotta love the Sultan. It's just a cool car. I got this one built up, painted, you know, a Subaru blue. Got the Subaru, you know, bug catcher intake here on the whole thing. It just grabs every kind of thing that you, right before it hits the windshield. It's quick. Is it the fastest of the sports cars? No. Is it the fastest of the four-doors? Maybe. There are other four-doors that might have taken it down. But it's quick enough. And then this was going to be my heist car. But again, I have another car that will do more of a job for that. And we'll get to that later. Now, this is actually a version of the car I've been talking about. My heist car. This is, you know, this isn't the one. Because this one hasn't been modified. This is a stock one. The only way you get this green is with the original version of this, and I got them on the 50% off sale, so I got two. And just so I could have one that looks like it came right off an army base, because that just looks so cool. But I did want one to fool with, and that's my actual, you'll see that when we get there, when we get to that part of the garages. But this is my Bone Stock Collector's Insurgent. I thought maybe I could transfer it to another character. But no, you can't. It doesn't seem like you can move any kind of hardware between characters. So we've got this going for us here. We can drive that whenever we feel like it. And then we're back around. Here's the T-Bird. There's the Sentimental Garage. Okay, now here is my working garage, okay? This is the one I go to. I actually just left the session and came back to it. So I teleported myself back to my main garage. And this is the White Elephant. This is my go-to vehicle for just about everything. It's quick for the size that it is. It looks cool. I have like kind of a Jason the Wheeled Warriors paint job going on it. It is fully modded. It's got all kinds of stuff. And the interesting thing is that I didn't yet do the heist that you need to do to unlock this so you can have it in your garage. But it when it was on sale, 50% off, they took away the requirements for that. So, completely lucked out there. Got myself this wonderful armored vehicle, and it is tough. You're not invulnerable, because if you got a good shot, they'll take out the windows. If they made the windows bulletproof on this, it would be completely overpowered. I mean, it would just be ridiculous, and I love that truck. I mean, I really love it. It's really great. This is my Willard, and you're wondering, well, gee, what's the big deal about a Willard? I've actually done this up as close as possible to the car I used to drive in high school. That's right. Now, obviously, it wasn't a turboed out kind of thing. It just had the stock 3800 engine. It was an 81 Regal. But and this is probably closer to an 88 Regal, you know, that kind of thing. But I've done this up in the same paint, same interior. Mine wasn't a lowrider. No, nothing fancy like that. It wasn't a V8 turbo. But that's another walk down Sentimental Street. And I do actually drive that pretty frequently. Now, this is my Dominator. I mean, for the longest time, this was my racer. It's done up pretty much the way my father's Mustang was. He has a 69 Mach 1. It is, most of the gold is now primer. It definitely needs a little bit of work here, but we're on that. We'll get to that. At some point we will do a video of that. But this is, again, another sentimental favorite. I did it up because I could. Love that gold Mustang, even though the tail is all over the place. And like that, and so. Now, here's another tribute car. You know, back before my parents got married, and when my grandfather was selling cars, and he sold cars most of his life, this he got, off the lot. My mom picked this one up. She had an actual 66 GTO, which is pretty close here. That's about the color it was, and there's all kinds of stories about that, you know. I recall, my great-grandfather or my great-great-uncle Sam was going to the hospital. She was driving my grandmother and her sister to the hospital, and they beat the ambulance there. It was a fast car, 389 with three deuces. And, you know, that's just one of the kind of car when I was going to get myself a Buccaneer. That was how I was going to do it up. In a similar fashion, and again, the color of these cars is kind of ironic. But my mom's cousin had an actual Crossfire that was very similar. I think it was a little bit more silver, a little lighter blue, but that's as close as it could come. This here, when I grabbed it, this is the best car you can steal. It's the fastest car you can steal. Not that you shouldn't stick with the Entity. If you can make the Entity go fast, if you're good with the style on that car, the Entity will still take it. But this car is definitely a competent racer, and I've done it up in tribute to my late uncle, God rest him. God rest you, Uncle Butch. That was one car that he had. Eventually, I think he traded this in on a, what the heck was it? The Dodge, the station wagon one. Magnum. He traded it on a Magnum. So he had a black Magnum for a while. So that's it. If you ever see me with a black Magnum looking car, if they ever introduced that to the game, then you'll know where that comes from. Now, this car. We've got the Mariachi car. This is a big deal here. Check this out. You gotta check this car out. We'll get on here. Look at this. Look at just what you got going here. No radio. You got guitars in the back. An empty bottle of tequila on the dash here. All kinds of stuff going on. A hat. You got a sombrero in the back. And the only way you can get this car is there's a certain event that happens, and I have it in another video. We'll throw a link in the description. where basically they have a Thelma and Louise tribute playing out with a car at the edge of a cliff, and a bunch of police have it surrounded. There's a helicopter, and if you just watch the event play out, Thelma and Louise, there, the two women in this car, drive it off the cliff. So what you have to do is snipe them both before, at least snipe the driver before they can go off the cliff, and then you can steal the car if you can get past the police. It's a little bit of a challenge. I've done it, and the car does not perform well by any stretch. You can't really use it for anything, but it's an accomplishment car. So we're gonna keep this one, and that's what we're at there. There it is. Mariachi Tornado, we love you. Even though none of your gauges work. Actually, the speedometer looks like it works. It's got a 180 mile an hour speedometer. Why would this car get 180 mile an hour? Is that a digital shift indicator? What? That show your what gear you're in? No. It's just a classic lights up kind of thing. Yeah. Woo! Woo! Oh yeah, look at the speed! Let's take this back in. Let's get out of here. And the last car we've got going here is our most recent car, of course, that we start out with, the Yuga Classic. It's the Mystery Machine. And I thought about shuffling some cars around and putting this one in the next garage because it really does fit there more than anything else. But, well, you'll see what I mean in a minute. Not less than a minute. And here we are. Here is my homage garage. That's right. Here we have cars that are from movies or other kind of things. You know, other games. Here you've got the car from 48 hours and another 48 hours, and I know it's not exact, but that's as close as you're going to be able to get. This is another one of my early cars. This is one of the earliest cars I actually put together. And it is a nice cruiser. I do like it. I do like it a lot. And, of course, we have the family truckster, you know, who doesn't love the vacation movies, and that has got to be one of the... That has got to be one of the slowest cars in the game. It really does. It's just unbelievable. But it is very durable. Then, of course, we have Tommy Vercetti's custom Sabre Turbo. Actually, it's not a custom. This is what's customized, but I mean, you know. That's the Tommy Vercetti Sabre Turbo. As you can see, I even put really, really simple wheels to kind of, you know, mimic the way it looked in-game in that other game. That custom Sabre Turbo, you got. Now I was thinking I could swap out the Yuga with the custom Sabre because the other cars in here had to do with TV shows or movies, and this is a video game tribute. But I mean, it's fine right here. You know, it fits. Then you have the Dubsta 6x6, which is of course one of the cars Richard Hammond drove in Top Gear. Love that episode in Dubai. It was just really hilarious, and I had to get one of these once I saw I could get one, and it's in exactly the same paint. Or as close as I could make it to his Dubsta 6x6. So there you have that. That's why we have here in the tribute garage, the homage garage. Now, this car is the reason why the homage garage is a 6-place garage as opposed to a 10. I really felt like the Mirthmobile did not belong in an upscale apartment. You know what I mean? This, you can see where we're at here. Let's hop in the Mirthmobile. Which, how am I driving out? Magic, that's how. You can just drive out. And again, let's ponder this for a moment. Okay, check this out. Here we are. This is my northernmost base, okay? And base of operations. You can't really get a 10-place garage up on the north part of the map. Rockstar, you should work on that. But what we have here is what looks like a one-car garage. Maybe a two-car garage added on to the house, and you drive into this one door, car barely fits through it, and magically, where did the other two doors come from? Like, where's the other door? You got two doors now, it's a six-car garage, the physics here blow my mind, and it's just how it is. But I really thought that the Mirthmobile should be out in the suburbs, and so that's why this year, and this is my main racer. I haven't had the heart to change the wheels to the off-roader simply because I matched those up with the back wheels on the real Mirthmobile. And so that's just something when I race this, I'm going to have to adjust for that and be careful with the bumps, because it is the Mirthmobile and I do love it. And there's a video on how you can make your own Mirthmobile too. You can do that. Everybody can have a Mirthmobile. Everybody should have a Mirthmobile. Especially with the announcement of Wayne's World 3 coming out. Will we see the return of the Mirthmobile? How can we not? I don't know. Maybe they'll do something like have them in a Chevette or something. That'd be. No, you need a Pacer. Which would be a collectible by this point. I mean, you know, it's... And then the final tribute car is my Futo. It's an Initial D Futo, as you can see. We've got this tricked out as much as we got. I think we've got the proper wheels on it. You got the whole crazy exhaust thing going, and it just slides around like crazy. It's a wonderful little drift car. Race that at your own risk if you like going kind of off, especially if you're in a stunt race. Woo, boy, that's, you want to live dangerously there. It'll slide all over the place. And so there you have it. I have one other garage, and that's the holiday special garage. But I have that detailed in another video. We'll put a link for that in the description if you want to go see it. And eventually we'll have the sixth garage, but not just yet. So on that note, this is just like a little bit of a talking video. Let's take a little drive in the Mirthmobile. Let's do that. I'm trying to think of what else I had to tell you. Let's go for a cruise. A night cruise. We got Shaggy in the Mirthmobile. How dissonant is that? We're cruising around here. Now, as I said, I've got races planned out through March. I've got follow-up planned out through the end of the year. I don't know what I'm going to focus on in the short term. You know, I've decided I'm not going to, you know, make sure that I have a constant stream of races going. I'm not going to tie myself down to a format. Wow, that was like completely random. You got issues there, son. I'm not going to try and make sure that I have a TF2 every Tuesday. I'm not going to try and chase anybody else's videos. I'm not going to try and do anything but make the videos that I feel like making. Play the games I feel like playing. I'm going to try and get you as authentic an experience as you can for what's going on with me here. And so there's certain things I want to do that are not video game related. There's other videos I want to make that actually involve a camera. I do have two other channels on YouTube which you should check out. And we'll put links in the description of those. You know, I've got other websites. I've got a blog that I've... A couple of blogs, really. Although the Basin System Services blog has been really neglected. I haven't updated that page in a long time. And I want to get a little bit caught up on some other things, you know? I want to get caught up on the blogs, caught up on writing, get back to writing the book a little bit. So, don't get me wrong. I mean, I'm an avid gamer. You're going to see game videos coming up here. But I want you to know that although if you don't see me doing like a couple of days where there's only a couple of videos a week, not like I'm walking away from this thing if there's a break in the action or something like that. But I'm definitely going to try and think of new things to put up, new things to play. You know, the last thing you want to do is come up to the game and say, oh, I have to do a race today, and I really don't want to do a race today. That's because that video is not going to work. The energy's not going to be there. Let's go out to the beach. We started on the beach, we'll end on the beach. That's not exactly how I intended to end on the beach. Come on, you can do it. Okay, well, then we made it to the beach. It's the beach. There's so much mirth here. So I'm going to keep making videos, but I want you to know, in case, you know, you're not seeing something for a little bit, it's because I've got other things planned, other things I should work on. I've got other methods of communicating out to you guys. You got to check the Twitter. Got to check the Facebook pages. I have, I don't know how many pictures I have to upload, screenshots from games, stuff like that. I gotta get myself a little caught up. I'm caught up on everything. And right now I think I'm caught up on videos. I've got videos that'll be popping up for months. And it's just like that. Don't get me wrong, probably I'm gonna hop out of this video and play some Team Fortress 2. It's just how it's gonna be, and if that works out well, there'll be a video. But just, I don't want you to think, guys, that I'm going anywhere if things slow down a little bit, or that, you know, don't lose heart. I'm, after this huge blitz of Black Friday, I'm gonna, you know, maybe tomorrow I'll be like, nope, I just want to do nothing but video games. But today, I'm saying, look, just in case you see me doing other things, check out my other things. I think you'll like them. You know, there's other things going on. There'll be a whole bunch of links in the description. I'm not even going to do the put them on the screen thing. Check the stuff out. See if you like it. Let me know what you think. I mean, we got, you know, videos of people dunking themselves in ice water, all kinds of stuff going on. You know, polar bear plunge kind of stuff, all kinds of stuff that happens up here in Northeast Pennsylvania, stuff that you might not expect, and all kinds of stuff out there to see. So that's where I'm at. That's kind of the channel update. I'm going to keep doing it. I'm not sure, you know, we might introduce a little bit of Kerbal Space Program. I might get really back into Freelancer. I was talking with some of my old Freelancer mates, and we're seriously thinking of making a go at that. So this might shift to a more spacey channel for a little while, but you'll still see some Grand Theft Auto. You'll still see some other things. We're not going to abandon anything, just so you know. And on that note, while I'm stuck here on the rocks, this is the Black Knight. Have a great night, everyone. Okay, so I guess we just have a cow on the roof now. That's like a thing. Whew. See, television, no. A refreshing glass of green juice. Gurgle. Blah. Nothing good on TV anyway. Time to relax. Time to take a nap. Sleepy time. Rockstar, why'd you make it so that, you know, they could pull up the covers? This just looks goofy. It does. Totally goofy. Yeah.